morning, dear students. I welcome you all to today's class. And in our today's class also, we are going to discuss about the chapter 2 only from history, that is from trade to territory. Where in our last period or previous period, we discussed about the Battle of Buxar. And Battle of Buxar was mainly fought between Britishers as well as the then Nawab, who was known as Mir Qasim. So after defeating Sirajuddin, after his death, Mir Jafar became the Nawab. And after Mir Jafar, who was the puppet ruler, because he was completely under the pressure of British, and he was just a puppet ruler because the entire power was in the hand of British. And after him, his son-in-law, who is called as Mir Qasim, became the next Nawab. And after that, after Mir Qasim became the next Nawab, he refused the privileges which were received by the Britishers during Mir Jafar's period. He refused to give those privileges to the British, and that has led to the another battle called Battle of Buxar, which was basically fought between Mir Qasim and some other Nawabs also Mughal emperor. So during after that, after Battle of Buxar, which was again owned by the British, so now the British became more powerful after defeating the two Nawabs, as well as after being victorious in two battles, the Britishers become very powerful, and now they have started leading their life like a Nawab. Okay, so here we are going to discuss the today's topic called company official becomes Nawabs. Because British, they have came to India in the form of East India Company, and those who were always working in the East India Company, and also the administrative section of or you can say administrative officials of Britishers, now they have started leading their life like Nawabs. Because Nawab, usually they used to have a lavish kind of life. They used to get everything whatever they want, or as a whole they have the power, they have the rule in their hand. Now in fact the Britishers also have, the British officials has also started leading their life like Nawab. Okay, so that's why the term Nawab, which was used, actually it is an anglicized means it is an English form or English name of the term, Hindi term Nawab, where basically the Nawabs has a luxurious life, a lavish life along with power. So similarly, British also have started leading their life like Nawabs. Okay, and everyone was fear of British now, because they have become the powerful kind of ruler in the country, so in the territory of India. So that's why everyone is afraid of British, which is called as that everyone was on the mercy of British, means everyone was afraid of British, because they have become the very strong as well as powerful administrative. Now after the Battle of Plassey, the actual Nawab of Bengal were forced to give land. So when the Battle of Plassey was also won by the Britishers, so the Nawabs of Bengal, the regional Nawabs of Bengal, they were asked or they were forced to give the land as well as their property to, or as well as money and wealth, to the company officials. They were forcefully asked to give those property as well as the wealth to the British officials in the form of what kind of gift? Okay, personal gift to the British officials or British administrative officials. So it was happened after, even after the Battle of Plassey. But after defeating the Nawab of Bengal, even in the Battle of Buxar, now British become more powerful and everyone is afraid of British. That's why everyone is under the control of British now. Now Robert Clive, who was the army commander, or you can say commander or general of British, was appointed as the governor of Bengal now. after Battle of Buxar, which was fought in 1764. After winning that, Robert Clive was appointed as the governor of Bengal in 1764 itself, after being victorious in the Battle of Buxar. So he was asked to remove corruption in the company administration. Actually, he was appointed because he was the leader for lead for fighting against the Nawabs during Battle of Buxar, and because of his leadership only, the British were able to defeat the Bengal Nawab, and they become the supreme power in the Bengal, and that's why he was made as the governor of Bengal in 1764. So he was basically appointed, or he was appointed as the governor general just for one reason, that to remove corruption in the company administration. In their company administration, in British company administration, if there are some people who all were using, officials were using the company pass for their own personal business, own personal profit. So to remove all those corruption, this Robert Clive was appointed as the governor of Bengal. But in return, what happened? Robert Clive himself were engaged in doing the corruption, okay, because he was cross-examined in 1772 by the British Parliament, which was suspicious of his vast wealth, because he had accumulated a large amount of wealth from India, trading from the East India Company. So he was suspected, even involved in corruption by himself. Though he was appointed to remove that from the British administration, but he himself were engaged in doing that particular corruption activity. Although he was acquitted and he committed suicide, for this particular reason he had felt insulted, and he was as he was doing so much for the company, but he felt he was acquitted, and he committed suicide in 1774. So he died in 1774, and it was a suicide from his side. So not only all company officials were like that, some of them were even good only, because every officials who all were working in the British administration, they were not being able to accumulate or get that much of money and wealth. Only Clive, who was succeeded making large amount of money and wealth, that's why he was suspected even involved in the corruption. But other company officials were not being able to accumulate so much of wealth like Clive. Many have already died because of in India, because of the war called Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar. These two were already, and some of them have also died because of some diseases which were spread in the country during that time, during the diseases. And then it would not be right to regard all of them as corrupt and dishonest. That's why it is said that all the company officials or all the administrative officials were not corrupted. Some of them were even not dishonest also. They were honest to the company. They were loyal to the company. Everyone were not like that. Many of them came from humble backgrounds, because some of them, they are from good background, honest. They were honest, they were loyal, because of they have come from a very good background, from their family maybe, and their uppermost desire was, but their only desire was to earn more money from India and return to Britain. After earning more money from India, they can return to Britain and lead a very comfortable life. So many of the officials, their willing was to earn more profit, earn more money, so that they can lead a lavish life in their own home country, that is in Britain. So all of them were not that much corrupted, but they wanted to earn more just to have a very comfortable and lavish life in their own home country when they return back from India. Those who managed to return with wealth led a flashy lives and flaunted their riches. So those who were able to manage that like no personal trade or profit from the East India Company for their own personal purpose, they were started, or they have led a very flaunted and very lavish life, very comfortable life. Though some of the officials, they have early died due to Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar, where they fought in that, and also some of them have died due to some diseases which were spread in the country India. But everyone were not being able to succeed for collection of money or profit from India, as like that of Cleve. But they have, many of them have died, and some of them, their main, they belongs to a very good background, honest background, but they wanted to earn more to have a comfortable life in their home country. So some of them, they were able to manage a large amount of wealth and return to their home country, and they started to lead a very flaunted and lavish life. So that much for today. So what we have discussed today is about the the company officials who became the Nabab. They lead the life of like Nabab, because after like defeating the Bengal Nawabs in two battles, that is Battle of Plassey and Battle of Buxar, they become the very powerful. British become very powerful, and due to that reason, they have started accumulating large amount of wealth, and some of officials have already managed to succeed in the collection of wealth from India, and they return back to their own home country for leading a very lavish life. So after that, when Cleve was appointed as the governor of Bengal, so at that time period only, the British officials started to have a life like Nawab of India, because now they are powerful and they are leading a very lavish kind of life. So that's all, is the very simple topic. It is only about the how the officials have become like the Nawab. Okay, so please note down the points in your copy, and as you have test in the next Friday, please do prepare for the test for your chapter 1. Okay, students, thank you very much.